This is an early example of the work I did. In fact, before I went to Japan, so this was made about 28, 29 years ago. It's handmade steel. I think this steel was made by a man called Doc Price in Plymouth. And I just got the book on Akasaka tsuba, and I was really taken by the very graphic Akasaka design work. So I was living in a farmhouse down in Cornwall, a place called Tregender Manor. There were lots of ferns everywhere. It seemed appropriate. Ferns are not particularly non-Japanese. What I really like about this is the patina and the texture. This is nearly 30 years old and it's still in pretty good nick. It's been handled a fair bit, I think, over the years. And the other thing this represents as a little milestone is the dot inlay, the little spores on the ferns, which I turned into a decorative motif. I figured out how to do dot inlay. So these are all done in the sort of classical dot inlay technique and made the various punches. I'd figured out how to make punches, and also this low relief carving. I'd made chisels. It wasn't difficult for me to make chisels. I knew how to make tools, and the cutting edges seemed intuitive to me. I'd done a bit of hand engraving as part of my apprenticeship as a goldsmith, so making the tools wasn't a big problem for me. And of course, piercing, I was just using a jeweler's piercing saw. But I can see the lamination in the steel. And the idea of allowing the design just to sneak off the edge, that was something I'd seen in the Akasaka works. And it just appealed to me. And the rhythm of flow of the design. I made a piece around about the same time of ivy leaves, which I believe is still on a sword being used in the eye to this day. In fact, I made a set of fittings to go with it a few years ago, so it's about a 20-year gap, and that was really nice. It wasn't the first time, in fact, I've had to make extra fittings for pieces I'd made at the beginning of my career. The funny thing was, I'd made about 25 or 30 tsuba like this before I went to Japan, and I couldn't sell any of them. I think I managed to sell maybe two pieces in all that time. So it was really, really tough going, but you know, you keep doing what you can. So of course this sold sort of 25 years or 20 years after I made it. I think I'm still satisfied with my youthful work. And my monogram, FH, I didn't think it right at that point to use a Japanese name, so I just devised a little signature that wasn't too out of place. So most of my early work has that mark, FH.